We want to match the linear equations to the correct graph. There are several ways to approach this, but notice how all the equations here on the right are solved for y, or are in sloped-intercept form, which is the form y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope of the line, and b is the y-intercept of the line. So we're going to match these by comparing the y-intercepts and the slopes. So let's go through each equation and identify the slope and the y-intercept. For equation A, we have y equals 1x minus 4, so the slope is positive 1 and the y-intercept is negative 4. For equation B, we have y equals negative 4. There's no x term, which means the slope would have to be 0 and our y-intercept is negative 4. Next we have y equals negative 0.25x plus 3. The slope is negative 0.25 and the y-intercept is 3. D, we have y equals negative 2x. If we want, we can write negative 2x plus 0. So the slope is negative 2 and the y-intercept is 0. For y equals 2x minus 4, the slope is positive 2 and the y-intercept is negative 4. And then finally for F, we have a slope of negative 0.45 and we have a y-intercept of 3. So looking through these six equations, let's focus on B first, where we have y equals a constant. We should recognize this as a horizontal line or a line that has a slope of 0. So looking at the graphs, notice how there's only one horizontal line, that's line 5. Notice how it does intersect the y-axis at negative 4. So equation B matches with line 5. Let's go ahead and cross those off. Now let's take a look at equation D. Notice how it's the only line that has a y-intercept of 0. It also has a negative slope, which means the line is decreasing or it goes downhill from left to right. So looking at the graphs, notice how there's only one line that passes through the origin or has a y-intercept of 0, and it is going downhill from left to right, which means it has a negative slope. Therefore, line 6 matches with equation D. Now notice that lines A and line E both have a y-intercept of negative 4. So looking over at the graph, we already found the horizontal line. So there's two lines remaining that have a y-intercept of negative 4, line 1 and line 2. Well, notice that equation A has a slope of positive 1 and equation E has a slope of positive 2. They both have positive slopes and therefore they're increasing or going uphill from left to right. But because E has a larger slope, it should be going uphill faster or increasing faster. So again, looking at line 1 and line 2, notice line 1 goes uphill faster and therefore has a larger slope than line 2, which means line 1 would be the equation where the slope is positive 2, and line 2, that's still increasing but not as fast, would have to match with equation A with a slope of positive 1. That leaves us with two more equations, both that have a y-intercept of positive 3, equation C and equation F. We take a look at the graphs again. Here's the y-intercept of positive 3. Notice how both lines are going downhill from left to right or decreasing, but looking at the equations, one of the equations has a slope of negative 0.25 and the other has a slope of negative 0.45. Well, negative 0.45 is less than negative 0.25, which means for equation F, the line would be decreasing faster or going downhill faster. So notice how line 4 is going downhill faster or decreasing faster, which means line 4 would match with equation F. And line 3, that's decreasing but not as fast, would have to match with equation C. So instead of having to graph each of these equations, we should be able to match them by comparing the y-intercepts and the slopes. I hope you found this helpful.